Welcome to shell scripting tutorial. My name is Ravi. In this video session we are going to see about Linux basics. Okay, so the ultimate video tutorial by rkit.co.in. So in this tutorial we are going to see few basic things. Okay, basics of Linux, features of Linux, flavors of Linux, and Linux architecture. Okay, so what is the features of Linux? Okay, it's the Linux operating system is very portable. Portable in the sense any hardware, the minimum hardware is required, like the memory is which can write run on 512 MB. The minimum memory is required as a 512 MB, and the CPU also does not require in a much higher hand. Okay, it's just required in a few basic CPUs also which the Linux operating system can run. And any device like the mobile or the tab or the basic hardware is required for the Linux operating system to be installed. Okay, in the sense the any hardware platform. Open source, so the Linux operating system is an open source. Okay, in the sense the source code is freely available. Source code is freely available. You can do whatever you want. Okay, whatever the modifications you want, which you don't want to like. Okay, you can just modify as you want. Okay, that is the freedom we can get it from this Linux open source. Okay, multi-user access in the sense the multi-user system means multiple users can access the system resources. In a sense, the multiple users at a time connected to the system and work their own things. Like the some user is going to execute on a shell script, some user is going to execute on a Python script, and some user is going to browse for the internet or something like that. Okay, so in a sense, multiple users at a time they can connect to the system and they can work on. Okay, multi-programming in the sense the Linux is a multi-programming system means multiple applications can run at same time. Okay, in the sense any program you can run on the Linux operating system, just not only like if you open one program you can close another program. Okay, simultaneously you can run the multiple programs on the platform. Okay, shell. Linux provides a special interpreter program which can use to execute the commands of the operating system. In the sense the shell is an interpreter. Whenever you type in any commands, okay, the command will be executed, okay, on the shell. Okay, security level. So the Linux security is compared to the any other operating system which is highly secured, okay, highly password protected, and control access to the specific files. Okay, encryption of data is also available on the Linux. Okay, so flavors of Linux, here are the few flavors we have. Okay, not only this one, we have so many flavors in the Linux, but these are the very few I'm going to show in this one. Okay, here are the Ubuntu Linux, okay, Fedora Linux, okay, Debian Linux, okay, Linux Mint, okay, Jorin Linux. Okay, these are the, like, we have the applications Red Hat Enterprises Linux, okay, Linux versions and the desktop version flavors. Okay, so many operating systems and so many things are there, like Scientific Linux. Okay, Scientific Linux is used for the like scientific methods, chemistry, you want to do something like that. Okay, you can make use of the Scientific Linux. Okay, like this, there are these so many we have flavors. Out of it, whatever the operating system you want, whatever the flavors you like, you can just use it, because all these flavors are built on the same Linux kernel. Okay, here is the Linux architecture. Okay, have the Linux architecture here. So the basically, if you have any hardware, so if you say something to the hardware which will not listen to you, because whatever the language you speak, English or Hindi or whatever it is, the hardware will not understand your language. Okay, the hardware will understand the low level language, which is only the zeros and ones. But how can you convey that zeros and ones to the hardware? Okay, so that is why we have the program is made as in a kernel. So these kernel program, what it will do is this kernel will talk to the hardware, says that whatever the you execute any shell's command on the shell, then it will go to the kernel and say, okay, this is the command is executed from the user. Then the kernel go to the hardware and says, okay, this is the command is executed and do the needful. Then the hardware do the is job and it replies to the kernel, and the kernel replies to the shell, and output will be displayed on the user interface. The user interface may be CLI or the GUI, whatever the user interface, like the applications like browsers or the like the programming things, so or the anything you can just run on the shell or the user interface, that will be go to the shell, and the shell will talk with the kernel, and the kernel will talk with the hardware. Okay, the kernel is a piece of code which interact with the hardware and the shell. Okay, shell is an interface, so where the users can execute the commands or the run the any applications on it. Okay, thanks. Okay, please subscribe to the channel, follow the series of tutorial. Okay, enjoy.